Hey, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Patrick. I wanted to make a video of the words for people who asked. I ask you to pray in agreement with me right now, brothers and sisters, and your prayers are in eternity with mine, no matter how when you pray with me on this video. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, we just come to you right now. Father, we ask you, Lord, to fill us with your Holy Spirit, Lord God. Lord, let your will be done in us as it is in heaven, Lord. Father, we pray right now for each person on this prayer list, Lord God Almighty, because lots of times, Lord, people ask for a word that what they want to hear, Lord. But, Lord, you have what we need to hear, Lord God. Lord, your Spirit, Lord, knows exactly what we need, Lord, for your word says, those who are led by your Spirit, they are the children of God. Father, I ask that each person would receive the word from you they need, not what they want, but what they need. Father, we give you the praise and glory, Lord, and we ask you to bless every person on this list, Lord, with health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love in the name of Jesus. Father, right now I pray for every person watching this video that they would have an ear to hear what the Spirit says unto the church. Hallelujah, Lord. And our eyes to see those things in the Spirit in Jesus' name. Hey, brothers and sisters, look, I want to say that just as I prayed that. We have to get out of our carnal mind. We have to get into the spiritual meat of the word, brothers and sisters. When you get a word from the Lord, sometimes the Lord speaks clearly and directly. It depends on the situation. Sometimes, or lots of times, he speaks in a parable form. Just like when you read the Bible, lots of those prophecies in the Bible aren't just straight out A, B, C, D. It's a poetic, parable way of speaking. And then just like the Lord said in almost every parable he gave, you know, and in Revelation, he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the church. The Lord explained to his apostles that the things that he said was not for everyone to hear. It's not to be heard in the natural, but in our heart. That's the reason why God speaks in these ways. Even though sometimes it's straight up, direct, no doubt, no question, no comment about what he's saying. But he speaks in parables and riddles, as it says that, you know, it's the plan of God, you know, to conceal a matter and then the delight of kings to search it out. So the Lord wants us to seek him. That's what it's all about. Lots of guys, people of you guys ask me for a word and then you'll, you know, and I've said, you know, don't tell me anything, but still, lots of people, they have a specific thing they're trying to find out about, you know, and the lesson is for all of us is God wants us to hear what he wants us to hear, what we need to hear, not what we're asking. You know, it's always what we need to hear. Just like as I've given this example several times, like Nicodemus, when he came to see Jesus at night, Nicodemus there in John chapter 3 said, well, you know, we know that you must have come from God because nobody can do the miracles you do except they come from God. Now, you know, Jesus didn't say, yeah, you're right, I came from God. No, he specifically spoke the word that Nicodemus needed to hear. And Nicodemus needed to hear. Nicodemus was an Israelite. He was on the Sanhedrin. He was a somebody and a big shot there in Israel and one of the top dogs there. And what did Jesus say to him? Except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven, John 3:3. So, well, he struck him right in the heart and said, hey, you're no different or no better than any Gentile or uncircumcised, pig-eating, you know, non-law-keeping Gentile running around in Rome anywhere in the Roman Empire. You're no better than them. Your birth on this earth means nothing. And I hope that all of you people who worship and exalt Israel as if it's God would hear what the Spirit is saying and what the Lord spoke to Nicodemus by the Holy Spirit. Jesus operated under the power of the Holy Spirit when he walked on this earth as the Son of Man. He gave up his position as walking as God and came and dwelt on this earth, as the Bible says. He thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but humbled himself even to a servant, even to the death on the cross. When Jesus was baptized, what happened? In all the Gospels, I got to say this theology, because there's lots of people, they have all these presumptiveness ideas and paradigms and all this information that exalts itself against the Word of God. So that's why I have to nail everything down with many Bible verses, brothers and sisters. Because there's always that smart aleck that's never even read the Bible that has their own vain imagination about Jesus. What does the Bible say? As I just quoted those verses, when Jesus was baptized as the Son of Man walking this earth, the Holy Spirit came on him and remained on him. Jesus operated in the power of the Holy Spirit. What did the Lord teach us? How to be a Spirit-filled man. If he came down as God, as Jesus told his disciples, can I ask my Father and he would send 12 legions of angels right now? No, Jesus didn't do that. He operated as a Spirit-filled man, using the sword of the Spirit wherever he went. Just like when he was tempted by the enemy in the wilderness. He said, it is written, it is written. He used that sword of the Spirit. The Lord operated the way and showed us how we cannot, not how to be God, like Kenneth Copeland and those guys say. No, he didn't show us how to be God. He showed us that if you're a Spirit-filled man filled with faith, then you can do all things, and all things are possible to those who believe, Jesus said. As he told us in Mark chapter 11, verse 22, 23, and 24, when he cursed the fig tree, and then Peter was like, woo, wow, that was cool, Lord. That's the tree you just cursed yesterday. That is awesome. And what did Jesus say? He said, have faith in God. You know, if you have faith of a grain of mustard seed, you know, whomso shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart those things he saith, when he says them, he shall have whatsoever he asketh. That's the text there. It is one of the best faith texts you can read. Mark chapter 11, verse 22, 23, and 24. Brothers and sisters, that reminds me, the video I posted yesterday in my dream about, I talked about Sister Mary with the crazy faith, and we talked on Facebook, and she was telling me that, you know, that her faith was revived and renewed and revived from watching some of the videos I've made in the past. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. That's what I'm saying. We're a team. We're a team. You know, I've made videos that was in my heart from the Lord and teachings of the Lord that inspired other people. And then Sister Mary turns around, having been inspired and revived through my teaching, and she's reviving and inspiring me in the dream to pray for the bride to be resurrected. So praise God, brothers and sisters, we are all a team working together. That's why the Lord sent out his disciples two by two, as they would encourage each other. If one gets, you know, we're humans, and we always can have a bad day. Somebody's having a bad day, and then the other one would encourage us, and vice versa. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters, for our brothers and sisters in the Lord. And I thank the Lord for all, you know, whenever I'm talking those things, it's always, brothers and sisters, there's always that 10% or whatever they are that need to be corrected. But most of you guys, praise God, you know, you're mature in the Lord. Lots of you guys who watch my videos are mature Christians. And you have a lot to offer to the body of Christ, and even several, many of you have ministered to me also. So praise God for that. You know, we're a team. And it's a shame, you know, but when we have preaching, of course, you know, it's some things are for us and some things are not. Some things we already know, some things we don't, right? So praise God for that. So let's go through this now that I've done a little preaching. Brothers and sisters, let me do these words while they're in front of me. Okay, Robert M. I ask you guys to pray for each of these people. Robert M. Sanctify thyself against the third day. Cleanse the temple, not the garments. Okay, let me explain that for those of you who cannot understand that. Because I'm, you know, if you read the Bible and all that, you know, and you know the Bible well, you can pick up on this stuff. It's not just the Spirit, but also the Word of God. So sanctify thyself against the third day. Now, this is talking about being prepared for the rapture. You know, and then the Lord has talked to me before about the children of Israel there. When the Lord asked them, you know, the Lord told Moses to get the people to come up on the mountain. You know, he said, prepare against the third day. And then they did all these things to sanctify themselves. They took a bath and all this stuff. Of course, this is the natural. That's what I'm saying. Well, see, I didn't even think about it. See, I didn't even think about this. I was thinking about, you know, don't do outward religious things. See how the Lord works? When I put cleanse the temple, not the garments, what I was thinking when I wrote this a little while ago, as I was praying, that cleansing the temple meant, of course, you know, that your heart, you know, being totally repentant and all those kind of things, and not, you know, being outwardly religious. But this is, I'm telling you, the text that the Lord is referring to, Not only did Jesus say, you know, clean the inside of the cup and the outside will be clean also, but, you know, it's not an outward religion. But from the text that I'm just telling you about, it just came to me from the Holy Spirit as I was talking. I mean, thank God, that's how the Lord operates. Prepare for that third day. Sanctify thyself against the third day. You know, be sanctified, be separated, be ready to go in the rapture. That's a type of the rapture when the children of Israel went up and the Lord came down on top of the mountain and spoke with them and Moses. And what part of the things they had to do to get ready was actually literally wash their clothes and literally take a bath. And so here's the Lord is referring to that, you know, cleanse the temple and not your garments. In other words, everything they did in the Old Testament, brothers and sisters, was a type and shadow of the New Testament. As it tells us all through the New Testament, particularly Hebrews written to Israelites about the gospel versus the law. You know, those are a shadow of things. So when Moses had them wash their clothes and all that kind of stuff, and they would take a bath, it's symbolic. Just like even water baptism in the New Testament. Paul tells us that we're buried with Christ and resurrected with him. You know, our old man dies and we're buried, then we're resurrected. It's a shadow and a symbol of resurrection. It's not literally baptizing you. The water is not literally washing your sins away. The blood of Jesus removes the sins from our spirit. Our sin is in our heart, you know, in our temple, not in our garments. That's the lesson. And it's not only for Robert M. You know, the Lord gives me these things to teach about too, brothers and sisters. It's for all of us, including myself. So that's the word I got for you, Brother Robert M. Paloma, and I already gave you this word yesterday, and the Lord had, you know, I added something to it in the email that I sent you, but I'll read it here. Justice and peace, or justice and righteousness, peace and mercy, the Lord delights in these in his people. And I added that in his people on this one, on this version of it. You know, because what I've been doing is writing them, then going back and praying over them again. Okay, and see if the Lord would add something or to it, or, you know, if I get the same thing again or not. Melissa R., my husband is Lawrence. The word I got for you, Melissa R., my husband is Lawrence, is evacuate from the situation you're in. Now, the Lord used the word evacuate. I believe that means quickly get out of the situation that you're in. That's all I know. Roy C., you know, that's all. I mean, I can only tell you what the Lord tells me, Sister Melissa, who's my husband is Lawrence. I wrote that on here because I think you'd asked me to pray for your husband. I can't remember. I've got so many people asking me. Roy C., extravagant details and sound doctrine will I give you. Search the scriptures. Roy C., Brother Roy C., extravagant details and sound doctrine I will give you. Search the scriptures, Brother Roy C. Rebecca V., doubt not my anointed, do my prophets no harm. Now, Sister Rebecca V., I don't know if this is talking to you or someone that's, you know, someone's doing that to you, or the Lord wants you to tell somebody. That's why when I give a word from the Lord, as I've re-prayed about these ones, especially ones that are a little bit odd like this one, pray about it and ask the Lord to give you an ear to understand what he's saying. Maybe it's you're doing it, you know, to somebody that's a prophet of God, or someone's trying to do it to you and God's trying to speak through you, or you're involved in a situation where the Lord wants you to give somebody that counsel. I do not know. Rebecca V., doubt not my anointed, do my prophets no harm. Carrie B.R., I just put the first two initials of your last name, B.R., Carrie B.R., sacrifice and sorrows have you known, but the way is made better, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Sacrifice and sorrows have you known, but the way is made better, Carrie B.R. Wendy Joan, trust in the Lord, acknowledge him in all of your ways. Wendy Joan, trust in the Lord and acknowledge him in all of your ways. Pauline C., I heard one word for you, and you need to study it, and that's all I know. The word is Sukkot. Sukkot. And I believe when I heard that you had been asking the Lord a question, and the answer to your question is Sukkot. Now, Sukkot, it's the Feast of Weeks, a.k.a. it ends on Pentecost. It's 7 weeks of seven. That's why they call it the Feast of Weeks. And the 50th day we call Pentecost. It's supposed to be the day the law was given. It was the day that the Holy Spirit came upon the church and baptized the church. And it's also, you know, symbolic of the Jubilee, 50 years, 50 days, Sukkot. Anyway, that's in the spring. It runs, you know, runs from time of East Passover to, you know, the resurrection for us, which Feast of First Fruits, starts with the day the Lord was crucified, Passover, and runs forward 50 days. So, coat. Let's see. Connie M. Connie M. Stress is a overcomer of your delight in me. Remove it by my spirit through faith. Connie M. Stress is an overcomer of your delight in me. Remove it by my spirit through faith. Connie M. That's you guys. When you, that's a great example. Somebody to pray for. Let's pray for Sister Connie M. She'll overcome stress to increase in her relationship with the Lord. Excuse me. Lucy G. Seek the Lord while he may be found. While he is near. Lucy G. Seek the Lord while he may be found. While he was near. Manuel C. Manuel C. Divide my word rightly and walk in my ways. Disaster avoided by it. You know, the Lord always says things in a way that I would never say it. That's, you know, as you flow in the Spirit. Divide my word rightly and walk in my ways. Disaster avoided by it. You hear that, Brother Manuel C.? Divide the word rightly and walk in my ways, and you will avoid a disaster. And I don't know what that is. You know, I mean, it could be in your marriage or whatever. You would be avoided. Wendy Forever, grief-stricken and vexed in spirit. Relief, sweet relief, cometh from the throne of my God. That's a pretty cool one. Wendy Forever, grief-stricken and vexed in spirit. Relief, sweet relief, cometh from the throne of my God. Renee H., call upon me and I will answer you. Jeremiah 33:3. Call upon me and I will answer and show you great and answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. Rebecca C. I hear the word centrifuge. Centrifuge. Okay, and then I prayed about it. And I believe, you know, that's the word of knowledge and the word of wisdom, I think, for Rebecca C. was centrifuge. You are in a centrifuge, and I'm getting you separated. Now, you can go look it up. A centrifuge is where you spin something around, you know, like when you get a blood test. Like in the lab, I used to, you know, be in nursing in the Army and send something to the lab. They put it in a centrifuge to divide out for different blood tests. Is an example of a centrifuge. You also hear about it with nuclear weapons and all this kind of stuff. But it's just spinning, you know, it spins stuff out to separate it. So the Lord has got you in a centrifuge, and I'm getting you separated. The Lord is separating you through a process, is what it means. The Lord is separating you in the process of separating you from maybe people who are bad, sin, whatever. You know. Nadine F. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. I will repay double for the trouble. Nadine F. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. I will repay double for the trouble. Now, in my opinion, I guess I'll try to give my opinion. You know, I haven't been doing that much, but in my opinion, maybe, you know, someone's done you wrong. That's my understanding of this. And you're thinking about, you know, revenge and all that, or you've just forgiven them. And the Lord is saying, hey, vengeance is his. He will repay them double for the trouble they've caused you. That's my understanding of what it means. Nadine F. Our job is to forgive and give it to the Lord. Tanika F. Soothing and calm is my spirit and my grace. Soothing and calm is my spirit and my grace. Delight in me. I have saved you from trouble and terror. Tanika F. Soothing and calm is my spirit and my grace. Delight in me. I have saved you from trouble and terror. You know, when I wrote this, I was thinking like some kind of abusive relationship or whatever. Something along those lines, maybe from the family or boyfriend, husband, or parents, or whatever. I don't know. But Tanika F., that's the word of the Lord for you. Soothing and calm is my spirit and my grace. Delight in me. I have saved you from trouble and terror. RJW. Christ is King and Lord of Lords. Strike the lentils with hyssop. And me and be redeemed. I put in me redeemed and be redeemed. Christ, RJW, Christ is King and Lord of Lords. Strike the lintels with hyssop and be redeemed. Now that refers back to the Passover. And they took hyssop, you know, of course, and they would put the blood of the lamb over the doorpost of their house so the angel of death would pass over. Wendy, asking for what she wants to know. I already emailed with you too, Sister Wendy, having to move into another town and all that stuff. Diverse temptations, overcome them by my patience and grace. Diverse temptations, overcome them by patience and grace. Ron G, strata, I hear the word strata. Strata, I think it's spelled S-T-R-A-T-A, strata. Scattered to the four winds in triumph is your sins removed. Like I say, I would never speak this way. Strata, and I was, you know, there's a stratosphere, I don't know, or way away. There's different meanings of strata. Scattered to the four winds in triumph is your sins removed. Ron G, maybe you've been praying and asking to be forgiven or whatever. That's what the Lord is answering you. Janine C, satisfy your thirst at my throne, flowing with living water. Janine C, satisfy your thirst at my throne, flowing with living water. It's a pretty cool one. Michelle C.R., I don't know why some of these I put this double letters. Michelle C.R., I am about to rend the veil between thee and me. Hey, that's a really good one. Wouldn't you like to have that word? All of you guys, and myself included. Michelle C.R., I am about to rend the veil between thee and me. That's pretty cool. The Lord's going to reveal himself to you. Praise God, Michelle C.R. Kathy S., it's a good one too, Kathy S. Elope with me to the heights of the heavens. I await thee on the high mountain of praise. Now that's from Song of Solomon chapter 2. Kathy S., that is an awesome one too, especially for a woman. Elope with me to the heights of the heavens. I await thee on the high mountain of praise. Lord wants you to praise him. Beth P., discharge your duties for my kingdom is at hand. Beth P., discharge your duties for my kingdom is at hand. Beth P., the Lord is commanding you to do what he's called you to do. Get it done. Get it over with because his kingdom is at hand. Al, then A-I-N. Al, A-I-N. Step up. Your next deliverance is in your hands. Al, A-I-N. Al, Ain, I guess, is the name that you're using. I don't know what your real name. It's your YouTube name. Step up. Your next deliverance is in your hands. Step up, comma, your next, comma, deliverance is in your hands. Jesus Lives 888. This is a really cool one too. This is a big promise. And when I wrote it, I had to pray about two or three times to make sure it's true. Jesus Lives 888. Troubles and sorrow are behind thee forever, the Lord said. I set you free and never to be bound again. How about that? How about that? Jesus Lives 888. That's an awesome one. Troubles and sorrows are behind thee forever. I set you free and never to be bound again. Those nevers and forevers is pretty big. I had to pray. I prayed about it two or three or four times and went back and over it again. That's the sure word from the Lord. Robert S., stress and strain. Free indeed, free indeed. Look around you. You are free. Walk away. The word of the Lord for you, Robert S., stress and strain. Free indeed, free indeed. Look around you. You are free. Walk away. Some sin that you think has you bound or situation, but you're not bound. You're free. Robert S. Stacy F. Sit upon the lap of your father and hear him speak. And in capital letters, and listen. Stacy F. Sit upon the lap of your father and hear him speak. And then in capital letters, and listen, and listen. The Lord's emphasized that you need to listen. Well, isn't that true for all of us? Stacy F., don't feel alone in that. Most people, even, the thing is, most people can't hear the Lord. And then those who can, they're not listening. I mean, that's a whole nother thing. Once people get, you know, most of the people I'm dealing with, I'm trying to get them to hear, have an ear to hear. But once you hear, then you also have to listen. That's a whole nother thing to deal with, of your maturity in the Lord for all of us. Chris, with a K, H, K-R-I-S-H, sidelined for a season and washed in the blood. Let the game begin. How about that? Sidelined for a season and washed in the blood. Let the game begin. Praise God. That's a pretty cool one. So, brothers and sisters, there's new people that's tried to message me and asking for a word. And I've asked people that you would email me. But I've been getting them off of YouTube and Facebook and all that as best as I can keep up. So if you've asked me for a word and you haven't received it yet, you'll just have to message me again until I get around to it. You know, the best I can, brothers and sisters. I have one name on the list now, a new name that I just got before I made this video, Anna H. She'll be first on the next list. God bless you guys. May the peace of the Lord be with you. Let's pray right now, brothers and sisters. Father, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord God, we honor you, we praise you, we delight in your holy ways. Hallelujah, Lord God, you are the Redeemer. Blessed be your name. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in us as it is in heaven. Lord, sanctify thy name and glorify thy name in thy church, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord. May our ways be pleasing unto you, Lord. Lord, lead us and guide us in the paths of righteousness for your name's sake, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We give you all the praise and glory, Lord. And we thank you, Lord God, that you would allow us to experience any of the gifts of your Holy Spirit, Lord. It's a faith-building exercise and a love-building communion amongst your children, Father. We honor you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen, brothers and sisters. I hear from the Lord that, you know, come and sit at the table with the Lord. Hallelujah. Delight yourselves in the Lord. Hallelujah. And prepare to sit at the table with him. For he, this, you know, the Lord is just telling me, just like what he told the apostles at the Last Supper, the disciples at the Last Supper. He said, you know, I think it's in Luke, how I've long desired, you know, and greatly desired to have this meal with you. At the Last Supper, the Lord is saying the same thing about the marriage supper of the Lamb. He is longing to and desiring to have that meal with us, to commune with us. But you know, brothers and sisters, when we pray, we're communing with the Lord. Talk about taking communion. And when you pray and you worship the Lord and all those things, we are having communion with the Lord. Especially as Jesus said, there's something about it where two or more are gathered in his name. He's in the midst of us. We become the church. Right now, you're watching this video. It's me and you and then other people watching it. But this right now, just two of us. The Lord is in the midst of us. We're communing with the Lord now. You know, we just don't, our eyes of our heart are not open. We can't see it, but it's true. We know by faith. Praise God that the Lord would, well, let's pray and ask the Lord that he would open the veil between me and him, you and him, for all of us. Like the one word that I got for the one sister. That he would, was it Melissa? I can't remember if I'm wrong. I'm sorry. He would open the veil for all of us, between him and us. Isn't that awesome, brothers and sisters? Praise God. Lord, open the eyes of my heart. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, 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 I want to see you. Hallelujah, praise his name. Hallelujah, the Lord hears his people. The Bible says his spirit inhabits the praises of his people. Praise God. Lift up your voice and worship him. Let him use you as an instrument to bring his presence to the lost and those without hope, the backslidden and the lukewarm. Lift up your voice and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glorify his name, brothers and sisters. Glorify his name. Hallelujah. God bless. Love you guys.